What do Batman and Harley Quinn do on the holiday season? Welcome to the Complete Story Series, where I take trade paperbacks and single issues and I break them down into digestible bites to help you understand. Then I read them dramatically back to you. All alterations to the panel, sex, and images are to prevent copyright problems, and all art is owned by its respective companies. With the holidays in full swing around us, the Comic Storian team also needs a break. So we scrounged up all of the holiday specials going on in all of your favorite books. We're going to bring them to you over this holiday season. I hope you guys enjoy. Today is going to be Batman, Silent Night, and Harley Quinn, Not So Silent Night, both in Batman Annual Number 1. There are 8.5 million people that live in Gotham, not including all of the commuters and passerbys. On average, the city logs 5.5 emergency calls per second. Needless to say, there are no silent nights. For Bruce, the Bat computer scans those incoming calls and compares them to fugitives and known hotspots, and then it sends him the GPS coordinates. Tonight, though, as Bruce swings through the city of Gotham, there's a ping indicating a system alert at Champion Square. There, a group of people in red coats begin to climb the statue as people begin to gather. And with the crowd silent, two of those people jump off of the top of the statue. And as they're caught, the crowds look and gasp at the sight. Bruce watches from afar, but the strangest thing happens at that very moment. People begin to take out their phones and cameras and they watch the performers. And Bruce notices the system went silent. The performers continue their act and Alfred radios that the alert system is working perfectly fine. Maybe he should just see this as a moment of grace. You know, we used to have a saying in the SAS, enjoy it while it lasts, bombardment will surely resume. Bruce smiles as the performers take their bow, and just as they wrap up, the system pings for an alert. Alfred asks Bruce if he needs the coordinates, and he tells him, no, I already have them. So Alfred tells him, very good, sir, back to the bombardment, as Bruce sets back out. It was Christmas Eve in Gotham City, and for a brief moment, there was peace all over the city. So what better way for Harley to celebrate than by breaking into people's homes to bring them all presents? That is, until Batman swings by and grabs her. A short while later in the Batmobile, Harley shouts, come on, did you think I was gonna dance on the front door? Not with my kind of rep. Besides, I actually have candy and cookies in my bag. Bruce looks at a bowl of pudding and asks what's that. And Harley says it's holiday pudding, in case she ran into her ex. Bruce takes the bowl and throws it out the window where it explodes. She says, okay, maybe I had one itsy bitsy bomb, but I really do want to do good. I'm a changed person now. As the two continue to drive, Batman says that he'll finish his patrol and drop her off at the city limits. Either that, or he can drop her off at Arkham. She tells him, fine. Can you at least put some Christmas music on before you dump me off? Bruce says that it's not that kind of radio. So Harley says, fine, how about we sing? I know you were singing with the cops one whole Christmas Eve. So Harley starts the song. Jingle bells, Batman smells, Robin Layden. Sorry, that just kind of popped out. So after that, Harley begins to sing actual Christmas songs. And Bruce notices two little girls dropping off some toys for charity. However, before they can make their drop off, some older kids begin to pick on them and throw one of the girls to the ground. One of the boxes opens up, showing a Harley-striped bat, and the girl starts beating the kids away. Soon, the kids begin to run off, and then Bruce notices something else going on. A man's dog breaks free from his owner and heads into oncoming traffic, but just before the car can hit it, a passerby pushes a hot dog cart in the way, causing the car to stop. Finally, the last thing that they see is a woman running from her apartment carrying a bag. Moments later, a man comes out trying to grab her, and the woman manages to hit the man with her bag. Just then, the man notices he ran into a parade of people all dressed as Harley. She continues singing at the top of her lungs, singing deck the halls with bales of holly, 'tis the season. And Bruce quietly says, to be jolly. Harley shouts that she knew he was singing along. And he tells her, it's time for you to go. Once Bruce drops her off, Harley shouts saying, thanks for leaving me out here in the cold all alone. And then Harley hears someone shout, hey, Nut Buckets is back. Harley turns to see Tony and Ivy and realizes Bruce dropped her off all the way back at home. Ivy gives Harley some hot chocolate, and with her new pep, Harley asks everyone who's ready to go caroling. Ivy says that it's 4 a.m, and Tony adds that everyone's asleep. So Harley shouts, not for long, and the group begins to walk down Coney Island caroling. You've probably watched a few of our other holiday videos at this point, or maybe this is your first one, but either way, I hope you all have some amazing holidays out there, and with that, I'm just gonna sign off right here. If you like comic books read dramatically back to you, don't forget to subscribe to this channel, and don't forget to follow me on Twitter, @ComicStorian, if you want to chat. I'll see you all next time right here.